Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 11th Annual Nobel Prize Award Ceremony. Here's your host, Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Thanks for coming out, everyone. You know, I just flew in from the 21st century, and whoa, are my tachyons tired. But I digress. Or should I say, deGrasse? We are joined tonight by people of many different cultures, but none so cultured as our first set of nominees. For most foreign film in a petri dish, we have Alexander Fleming for his repelling applications of penicillin. Edward Buckner for his improvements in the field of fermentation. And Barry Marshall, a man with the guts to drink his own experiments and the ulcers to prove it.
Personally, I prefer the technical awards. They just seem less pretentious.
And now, presenting the awards this evening is a man who needs no introduction. His Royal Majesty, King Gustav V.
Welcome, welcome, everybody. Marshall, you good? Oh, well, I guess he's disqualified. But we'll let him stick around for in memoriam. Thank you. All right, with no further ado, the Nobel Prize goes to Alexander Fleming for penicillin.
So, what are we up for?
Nicola's up for maniacal engineering, and Marie is nominated for one of the real awards.
Oh, snap! Recognition for lady science!
Let's not make a big deal out of that.
It is a little inspiring. I mean, the male-to-female ratio here is exceptionally non-Fisher.
Tell me about it. I have to beat him off with a stick. Beat him off.
Champagne, madame?
Move along, Romeo. Goddamn pervert.
Well, I'm just glad that a woman is finally getting recognized for her work.
Well said, Einstein. So progressive.
Way to break ground and lead the way into an era of equality.
I'm proud of you, Albert.
I've won before. It's really not a big deal.
Shush, 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 it's my category.
Many scientists try to push the boundaries of what is possible, but only a few choose to push the boundaries of what is responsible. Here are your nominees for maniacal engineering. Konrad Susa for his electromaniacal computer. Nikola Tesla for his apple-powered doomsday device. And Thomas Edison for his pear-powered doomsday device.
And the Nobel Prize goes to in failure to find a suitable candidate this year, no Nobel Prize shall be awarded in this category.
What? Don't listen with his legs.
Now, our next nominees have so much chemistry that even at negative 273.15 degrees Celsius, they're okay. Ladies and gentlemen, your nominees for the Nobel Prize in Chemistry. Marie Curie for her discovery of the elements radium and polonium. The Nazis for their development of all-natural Nazi brand Hitlerbot fuel. And little Philip for his adorable volcano project. Just look at him. His parents must be so proud.
And the Nobel Prize in Chemistry goes to Marie Sklodowska, Marie Curie.
This is ridiculous! Nobel Prizes!
This is your fault!
This is your fault!
He's your son!
This is Carol!
It's Sklodowska.
On to our next category. Who here is a fan of infectious diseases?
We lost.
Aww. No!
There. We all did our best, okay? And if they don't want to recognize that, then scheiße. Let's just steal the awards.
Yay! Go Nazis! 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 Nazis!
Sneaky little Nazis are having fun, stealing Nobel Prizes from everyone. They couldn't win their own, they were feeling so blue. Oh yeah. They're gonna steal your Nobel Prize from you. They don't really care if you're rich or old, they'll steal from you, or so I'm told. You discovered a star or a cure for the flu. Oh yeah.
Great work! Absolutely outstanding work! All right, who's next? Ah! And now for outstanding work in the field of chemistry. I present the Nobel Prize to Nazi 34.
Hey, that's you.
Oh, sorry. Congratulations, 34. Great work! Woo! Okay, that's everyone, right? Yeah. Actually, I don't think they got an award. What? What are you talking about? Who doesn't have an award? Is it you? Well, what the hell happened?
The last two awards?
Well,
what?
Also this, the super science friend. Oh, well, that's not a problem. I'm sure a room full of Nobel Prize winning scientists can figure something out.
Here comes Tesla! And whoosh!
Play it again!
Guten Tag, super science friends.
Da, licorice sticks! Nazis! What the devil are you doing here?
Your Nobel Prizes. Give them to us.
Mine? Never! You'll have to pry my Nobel Prize in Literature from my cold, dead hands.
Yeah, we're after the real Nobel Prizes. Now give us Curie's Nobel Prizes or we will be forced to take them from her. By force.
Huddle in! There's no way those filthy Nazis are getting their hands on your medals.
No one's even gonna get near them. Just leave it to us, the men.
We should just give them the prizes.
She's delirious with fear.
Ma'am, you're too close to the situation. Just let us handle this. I'm going to distract them. You guys get Marie out of here.
Right.
No, just give them the... Ah!
Never give in. Never give in. Never, never, never! Listen, Marie's not sure where they are right now. It's been a really long day, and she's tired, and she's got a headache. P.M.S.
Time's up! Fire!
This is no place for a lady. Gentlemen, charge! Yeah,
back to the days of trench warfare.
Yeah, me too. Patching up wounded idiots.
Oh, I forgot you were a field nurse.
A doctor.
Ouch!
I got it!
Guys, just listen to me!
No way! Your Nobel Prizes are too important! Priceless symbols for women everywhere!
That's so true, Freud! And I have to say, way to stand up for the respect of women! The ladies of the science community deserve a voice! And you, Freud, are that voice!
Just give them the,
Sir, they aren't surrendering. Call in the Hitler bot. Bring him in. Over.
Looks like someone's going to have to teach this thing some manners.
That is no way to treat a lady!
Oh, for God's sake.
Don't worry, guys, I got this!
Get him!
Stay back!
You idiots! At least use your powers! Hey, I've got a brilliant idea. Let's give them the f***ing awards.
Ah, I knew it. Stockholm Syndrome. Tell me, were you recently in Sweden?
We all were. You are an idiot. And if we give them the awards, this will all end.
God damn it.
Here, just take them.
And the Nobel Prizes in both physics and chemistry go to Nazi 27 and Nazi 83! Congratulations, you two. Amazing work.
Maybe we should go to your place instead.
I get it now. You don't need an award to validate your accomplishments. Your self-worth isn't tied to public acknowledgement. So by handing them over, you showed the Nazis that you were above their antiquated values, thus taking the moral victory.
Yeah, maybe. That or everything I touch becomes horribly irradiated. By the way, you're probably all sterile.
Hitler, where's he hid? Churchill shot him when he was a kid. Why, oh, why do they look the same?
Same, why do they look the same?
They are clones who share their DNA. They all have the exact same DNA. How do they travel through time and space?
Tesla, you look shocked.
They don't have a car that'll reach 88. They summon a demon to help name Barrera 2. Then they're gonna steal your Nobel Prize from you. They're gonna